greetings, and what a mulatto rants with Muscle and Magicka, and you, my friend, just accepted a quest. As we begin to wrap up this basic nutritional starting quest, I want to take just one quest to talk to you guys about your micros. No, gamers, I'm not talking about your uber micro. I'm talking about your micronutrients, vitamins, and minerals. Uber micro is still important, though. Now, we spent a lot of time on calories. How much should we eat to gain weight, lose weight, maintain weight? But it's equally important that we make sure that we use that food intake to provide our bodies with the nutrients that they need. So, make sure you got some points in herbalism, and let's go. Now, we've all seen those articles on the internet that want to tell us all about the 10 good foods and the 10 bad foods. There's always a little picture of a banana for some reason. FYI, I normally play a paladin, so let me bless you guys with a little bit of wisdom. In reality, there are very few, if any, foods that are actively bad for you, meaning you eat them and they actually do direct harm to your body. Typically, what you do have are two kinds of foods. There are foods that contain things that you need, like fruits and vegetables that contain micronutrients that your body needs to function properly, and then there are foods that don't contain quite so much of the things that you need. These are things like Twinkies, and of course, Pop-Tarts. Now, there's nothing inherently bad about this second group of foods. The problem comes when these less micronutrient-dense foods dominate your diet to the point that you're not getting enough of the micronutrients that you do need. So it's not so much about removing bad foods from your diet as it is about making sure that you include the good ones. Or, as we like to put it, having an inclusive diet rather than an exclusive diet. Think about it like this. If you've ever played an MMO or even a single-player RPG, then you know that a lot of times there are a number of food items in the game that don't help your stats at all. They're just there more or less for fun. It's okay to eat these fun foods. You want to be eating foods that you enjoy. Sometimes you get an achievement for it. What you don't want to do is run into a hard mode dungeon with nothing but fun foods. DPS are gonna need their critical hit food. Mages are gonna need their magic attack power food, because there are just certain stats, or nutrients, if you will, that your character needs. And while there's nothing wrong with an apple pie or a cream-filled donut, they're not gonna bring you any closer to hitting that mitigation cap and becoming uncritical. So, how many stat-rich foods do we need, and how much junk food can we afford? A good general rule of thumb for most people would be try to aim for at least 1 to 2 servings of fruit and 1 to 2 servings of fibrous vegetables per day. If you want to be a little bit more specific, then I'll source these recommendations from Eric Howells. If you're eating 2,000 calories or less, aim for that 1 to 2 servings of fruits and fibrous vegetables per day. If you're anywhere between 2,000 to 3,000 calories, then bump that up to 3 servings each. And if you're anywhere between 3,000 to 4,000 calories, bump it up to 4. If you're eating more than 4,000 calories per day, you could try to aim for 5, but if you can't quite fit that much in, don't worry about it. Now, I'm not saying that once you reach your micronutrient requirements for the day, it's a good idea to fill the rest of your calories completely with junk food. I think it's obvious that we still want to aim to compose our diet predominantly of whole, minimally processed, micronutrient-rich foods. However, you don't need to be afraid of that burger. There's no reason to fear that bowl of ice cream. There's nothing evil about that bag of candy, unless it's Sour Patch Kids. Those are evil. The big practical benefit to fruits, vegetables, and other micronutrient-rich foods is the fact that they tend to fill you up a lot better than processed foods. So if you're on a cut and you're on really low calories, it might not be a bad idea to eat more than just the bare minimum of your fruits and vegetables. On the flip side, if you're bulking on 5,000 plus calories, might not be a bad idea to throw in some ice cream, because good luck eating 5,000 calories of broccoli and spinach. So, if you gained some experience points, or maybe even leveled up, then give me a thumbs up. And if you want to come along on the next quest, where we tackle macronutrients, then subscribe and join my party. Until next time, you lotto rants, logging out.